Welcome to Tire Rack Testing. We all know that nothing lasts forever, and our tires are no exception. Eventually, they'll need to be replaced. This video is a revisit of a timeless tire performance question that we looked at all the way back in 2007. When is the right time to replace your tires? How much tread is needed to safely bring your vehicle to a complete stop during a full panic braking situation on a rain-soaked road? This test will be looking at two different vehicles, the common sedan and the popular pickup truck, with category-appropriate tires for both, a standard touring all-season tire for the sedan and highway all-season tires for the truck. We took the same tire and compared several sets at brand new tread depth, a significantly worn tread depth, and finally at the legal limits.
A new tire features deep grooves that channel water through the footprint to provide wet traction. Our test tires began at 11/32 of tread depth for the standard touring tire and 12/32 of tread depth for the highway all-season tire. Naturally, as a tire wears, tread depth decreases and the grooves restrict the amount of water that can pass through it. Our test tires had 4/32 of an inch remaining tread depth, the distance of an inverted quarter to the top of Washington's head. As a tire nears the minimum legal tread depth, water flow through is further reduced as grooves restrict or disappear depending on the depth of the tread features. Our test tires had 2/32 of an inch of remaining tread depth, the distance of an inverted penny to the top of Lincoln's head. Our test consisted of 60 mph ABS-assisted panic stops on asphalt covered by approximately 1 mm of water, typical of what's experienced during a heavy downpour. Speeds and distances were recorded until the vehicle came to a complete stop. The best view for comparing the differences between each level of wear was from the side, where the distances were most apparent. Unsurprisingly, as tread depth decreased, stopping distances increased significantly.
Just from full depth to 4/32 of an inch, the sedan took an additional 65 feet to come to a stop, and it was still moving at 35 miles an hour at the point where the full depth tire had already finished braking. It was even more severe at 2/32, taking over 400 feet to stop moving and passing the previously stopped tires at 50 miles an hour and 44 miles an hour respectively. For the first 100 to 150 feet, the fully worn tire was functionally ineffective and our driver was along for the ride. We repeated the same test with a popular pickup truck, and as expected, we saw the trend repeat, with braking distances getting longer with more wear. The pickup did take an additional 45 feet to stop on tires worn to 4/32 and was still moving at 29 miles an hour at the point where the previous tire had stopped. That again increased to 71 feet with the 2/32 of an inch tire over the full tread depth tire, with the fully worn tire passing it by moving at a brisk 36 miles an hour.
We repeated several runs of the test on both vehicles and all sets of tires and saw consistent results. Simply put, if the ground is wet and you're hoping to come to a stop, the more tread you have on your tires, the better.
Neither of them got better with more wear, which was ultimately the point. After all, if you just had to mash the brakes on a busy highway and you're looking in the rearview mirror, which one of these images would you want to see?
Obviously, drivers can't run on new tires all the time, but particularly for our daily drivers, we hope that they last at least a few years, with proper rotations, of course, but still, they're going to wear down over time. So again, what's really the answer for when you should replace your tires? Tire Rack recommends that drivers consider replacing their tires when they reach 4/32 of an inch of remaining tread depth, particularly if you live where it rains, which is most places. Of course, it's a personal decision to balance the value difference of running tires longer compared to the loss of performance and, frankly, safety of driving on wet roads. But that's why we test, to provide the information that you need to make the right decisions for yourself and your family. If you found this content helpful, informative, or just had a good time watching, consider giving us a like. Let us know what you drive and how often you change your tires in the comments below, and think about subscribing for the latest and greatest tire testing videos.